What's up? This is Al from Daath, and you are watching barebonesmusic.com.
Evil G, barebonesmusic.com. I'm here with Al from Daath. And sure, we're here to talk about, actually, your new solo project called Avalanche of Worms.
That's right. It's not really exactly a solo record because Emil from Daath did it with me, so it's more like a duo record. And we also had Sean Reiner from Cynic playing drums, so the contributions from the other guys in the lineup, besides Emil and myself, is so great that I have a hard time considering it really like a solo record. Mm-hmm. But it's definitely not Daath.
Right.
Yeah.
Speaking of that, what made you want to kind of explore creating a record that isn't Daath, and the kind of styles you wanted to kind of record that normally wouldn't fit a Daath record, but something that you artistically wanted to create?
Well, you know, Daath is what Daath is. Mm-hmm. We do what we do, and we don't really put limits on ourselves,
right?
But we have a certain personality or character to our sound, and feel that it takes place when the five of us create something, and you know, it does what it does. And I know that I can speak for Emil on this, and myself, of course. Daath is just one thing that we do. It's always been that way. It just happens to be the first thing that got noticed and went somewhere. But we've always been involved in lots of different projects, lots of different styles of music. We don't like to be limited to one thing. I mean, if extreme metal was all I did, I might shoot myself. I love it. I love it. You don't do metal unless you love it. But being stuck to one sound or one genre of it, or even one band, it can be a little bit limiting when you make music your entire life. So when this opportunity came about, it was very welcome. The label came to us wanting to do it, and okay, let's do it. We always wanted to do something like this. And then when we had the opportunity to get our favorite metal drummer of all time, it was like, more reason.
Right.
Why not?
Right. Well, you say that this album here, really, I mean, you've got a list of songs on the back, but it's really not a singular song. It's like one 41-minute piece. Talk about that.
Well, that's how it's meant to be heard. It's meant to be heard from start to finish.
Right.
There's no real breaks on the album whatsoever. A lot of people who hear it don't realize that they're on track 7 by the time 20 minutes have gone by. It's not really meant to be song. It's meant to be like a classical work, one collective piece. And yeah, of course, it's broken up into tracks or sections, and a lot of that is to make it easier for the end listener, I guess. You know,
right?
We care about you guys, but it's not really meant to be heard that way. I have a hard time when I hear tracks by themselves; just doesn't sound right to me. I feel like you kind of have to hear it all in order. You know, like same with some movies I like sure. There Will Be Blood or whatever.
Right? Yeah.
Where that last scene, which is like the most brutal scene in the whole movie, wouldn't have had the same kind of power if there wasn't that 3-hour-long buildup.
Right.
It's the same sort of thing.
Yeah, well, it makes sense. Talk about the time and effort that went into this record. You mean you're playing with Daath, you're recording, you've got, you know, you're constantly touring, and you guys spent like every free moment that you had on this record. And I read in the bio that it almost like killed you, just because how much time and effort. It was like you were just constantly working. Did that bring out even a better experience on the record as well?
Well, here's the thing. We don't see this like a side project or, we take everything we do equally seriously, basically. There's just because it's not Dooth doesn't mean that we're not going to put everything we've got into right. it. So, you know, between all our commitments, whether it's Dooth or Emil playing, you know, fill-in guitar for bands like Unearth or Chimera, or me doing sessions, between all that stuff, we had to find the time to do this. So at first we started working in, you know, like sporadic 4-day spurts mm-hmm. where it would just be like all in, like total immersion writing. And then right. we would have to stop. And then as deadline approached, it just got crazier and crazier and crazier because, like I said, we weren't going to shortchange the record.
Right.
We needed to put everything we could into it. But, you know, deadline was like, what, like 6 weeks away?
Yeah.
And the whole thing wasn't even written yet. And, yeah, that also stressed Sean out a little because he had right. to write drum parts for it. So everything was just done. It's like, it was just like a cloud. It's hard to really remember how it all went down. Just so many long nights. The funny thing was that, like, we were already on a really tight schedule.
Mm-hmm.
And then the studio where Sean was going to record his drums completely fucked him over. And and that had to be pushed back by about 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And he finally found a place that was suitable. And they had a 6-hour block ready. So, you know, most drummers on metal albums will take 5 days to a week to a week and a half mm-hmm. to record their drums. He did this entire thing in 6 hours.
Wow.
That's, you know, that's how the real deal session guys
right.
do their tracks. They'll cut an entire record in a few hours. And, you know, really, that's not something that really happens in metal too mm-hmm. often.
Right.
But, so anyways, we got that about the drums about 5 days before the record was even supposed to be started mixing.
Mm-hmm. So it's almost like
it was crazy. Yeah. Mark Lewis down at Audio Hammer in Orlando mixed it. Mm-hmm. And that was, you know, he has his schedule too. We couldn't push that back. Right. So it was somehow record enough to where we could go to Orlando and get Mark started. And while he'd be mixing, we set up a separate studio and we just record all night long, trying to finish whatever we could, give it to Mark the next day. Just be like, here, mix this. Literally worked up until the very, very end. Like a brutal drag out, knockdown fight to finish it. But here we are. It's done.
Now you, so tell me what this means to you as just a passion project for you. I mean,
every project I do is. Mm-hmm. If my name's on it,
yeah,
as anything other than engineer, because you know, if I engineer something, that's more like just a service I'm performing. But you know, if I'm listed as producer, writer, guitarist, or it's one of my bands, they're all passion projects. I wish every project that I was involved with could have the opportunities that Dooth has, mm-hmm. but you know,
right,
it's the way the cookie crumbles. So yeah, man, this right here is something that myself and Emil have wanted to be able to do for years, and we're definitely going to do at least one more under this name. So,
very cool. Just talk a little bit about Dooth. You guys are coming back over here to the States to record soon, start recording a new record?
June 1st, we're going to record the drums in L.A., and we mm-hmm. go back to Atlanta to finish it, and then to Orlando to mix it. But yeah, the new Dooth record will come out this year as well. And we're, I'd say, halfway into the writing process. Things are about to get crazy as soon right. as I go home, because we'll have 6 weeks to finish it up. And I think that it's going to be the most extreme record we've ever made. And I don't mean extreme in terms of blast beats everywhere.
Right.
And I don't mean like extreme. I just mean extreme in terms of what we do, in terms of what everyone's bringing to the table. It's like everyone, I don't know, since the last record has honed their superpowers and their unique abilities. And everyone's just looking to really, really just wipe the floor clean with our last record. You know, so it's fun.
Avalanche Worms. April 20th?
That's right, April 20th.
April 20th, pick it up. Spend the time, take the 41 minutes, listen to it all the way through. Pick it up, Eyal. Thanks for joining us, man.
Thank you very much for having me.
Hey, thank you.